Our 5 o'clock session will be hosted by my friend Jyoti. She is a full-time entrepreneur and content creator. She believes that copious amounts of humility with a little dash of humor has the capacity to heal the world. And do I resonate with it or what? So over to you, Jyoti. And Jyoti is going to host another entrepreneur who I absolutely adore. She is somebody who has brought these cute and nifty little sanitary pad disposal bags into the world. So over to you, Jyoti.
Okay, so hi everyone. Thank you so much, Sanjana, for giving me this opportunity first. And am I audible?
Yes, you are. Yeah.
Okay. So today I am extremely honored to be hosting Anisha, who is an entrepreneur, and she has, set out on this beautiful mission with, her venture called Swachh, that is here to uplift all the sanitation workers. So, yes, Anisha, I would like to first, it would be great if you could tell something about you first, about your journey before Swachh, how you started, how you got the idea, just everything.
Sure. Are you sure you want me to do that? I'm very talkative.
Once oh, I yeah, start, definitely. Definitely.
So, hi, everybody, and I hope you all are having a nice time. The previous session, obviously, was, a very therapeutic watercolor, so I hope you all have all enjoyed that. Good work, Sanjana. Kudos to you. All the best to you. Keep going.
Thank you. Thank you, Anisha.
Sure. So, pre-Swachh, I'm actually a retail professional. So, I've done my master's in retail management, post which I worked with Landmark Stores. So, before I completed my course, I was appointed as the national category manager for gifts. That's when actually I started loving retail. Having said that, I have been brought up in retail. My family business is off retail, so I know retail from when I was a child. But when I started working with Landmark, I started loving the volume-driven aspect of it. So that's when I knew, whenever I start out on something of my own, it is going to be retail, it's going to be volume-driven. And then I worked with Levi's. I was the buyer for about 28 stores. That was my last paid salaried job in retail. And besides Swachh now, I've joined the family business. So we have a retail store of cosmetics, accessories, skincare, personal care. We're basically a drugstore.
Okay, amazing. Thank you so much. So tell us everything about Swachh. Like, how did it come about? How did you come up with the idea? What is it that drives you to, a cause like this?
I just chanced upon, a show at the time. It was a Sunday afternoon, and, there was this show called Satyamev Jayate, which used to be a show. It was hosted by Amir Khan at the time. So I was actually watching that one episode, and when I was glancing through the TV channels, it actually spoke about menstrual hygiene, about sanitation workers, the plight that they face on an everyday basis across the country. And, they had pictures, they had visuals showing the dumping grounds. And, they also had people of the solid waste and collection handling, which is a Pune-based organization. So they came on the show, they spoke about it. They had real waste handlers, sanitation workers who also came on the show. They spoke, about their difficulties, the work and all of that. So as I watched it, I just thought, why not do something about it? So the first thought that came to my mind was, I have a retail store of cosmetics. We sell sanitary napkins anyway. So let me check what are the brands available of disposal bags and I will keep it in my store. So in 5 minutes, I looked up online. I couldn't find any. There was no, brand or no product, which was basically a disposal bag for a sanitary napkin. So obviously the retailer in me, in 5 minutes, I said, it's my job. It's my duty. I have the retail, education. I have the sources. So, why not try something like that? So less than 2 hours later, I actually sat with my mother-in-law and both of us, we actually sat and made, these bags using newspaper. And, we thought it was viable. It was something that could be done. So in 2 hours, Swachh was born. That is how, and fast forward 6 years later, we're a team of about 40 plus women. And until about 6 months ago, we were an all-woman brand. But now, you know, we have our ladies whose husbands, whose brothers have unfortunately lost their jobs. So, you know, they want to make Swachh bags along with their wives or sisters or mothers. And we're always encouraging them to do that.
Okay. That's beautiful. All the best for everything that you are going to do. The next question that I have is, what are the challenges that you faced in the early years? Like, I'm sure there must have been some challenges, business point of view, society, planning, anything and everything. Like, what were the challenges that you faced?
Sure. So any business does come with its challenges. In my case, I thought that, you know, I haven't done any market research, so that would be a challenge for me. But, you know, fortunately, it wasn't like that. My main two challenges were, one was changing the mindset of people. People come with a lot of preconceived notions. Like, you know, why should I spend on a disposal bag when I'm not going to touch it? It's a one-time use product. If I'm not going to come in contact again with it, you know, why should I be worried about it? You know, so that, you know, that is a red flag. And, you know, that was a huge challenge. So, you know, in fact, it's more the educated people who have this, you know, this kind of thinking. So, you know, educating an educated person is always a challenge, I say. And it's only come about by, you know, addressing them, talking to them, having real conversations with them, explaining why we're doing what we're doing. The second challenge is, you know, people obviously have different schools of thought. So there are some people who believe that, you know, newspaper is knowledge. You know, you gain knowledge, it's informative, it's educative.
Yeah.
Newspaper, you know, they say, you know, studying is Saraswati. So, you know, they worship newspaper in some aspects. So people don't like, some people don't like to use newspaper for discarding any sort of waste, especially if it is sanitary waste. You know, that is a challenge because these are the same people who will, you know, go and buy like a roadside pakoda or, you know, something using and, you know, keep it in newspaper. And again, it's exactly going to go to the bin anyway.
Yes.
You know? So these are also the same people who will go and sell this newspaper in kilograms, you know, to a scrap dealer. And what is going to happen to that newspaper? Again, it's going to go to, you know, roadside stores. So, you know, educating the people about what actually happens once you discard any sort of waste, solid, you know, or recyclable or any sort of waste, that has been a challenge. That continues to be a challenge, but, you know, we've been able to reach out to a much larger number now. So people do understand, you know, now that there's so much on social media, you know, there's so many conversations happening. So thankfully, we've been able to address that.
Okay, so majorly, how do you address something like this? I mean, how do you create that kind of awareness? Through social media only? Or there are these drives that you do offline? Like, you know, how does the awareness part come into place?
Sure. So when I started Swachh, that time I would take part in a lot of exhibitions. You know, so a lot of exhibitions, you know, they would also want to do something good for society. So, you know, they used to give me a small stall, you know, where I could sell my product, or if I didn't want to sell, I could just, you know, engage with customers there. So a lot of our awareness, I have had exhibitions. I'm from Chennai, so I've had exhibitions in Chennai, Bangalore, and recently in Bombay. So initially it was on that. And then obviously there's social media, you know, there's so many messages coming in every day on social media about, you know, why should I use a Swachh bag, or why should I use newspaper, or what if I don't want to use a newspaper, then what do I do? Or, you know, today I'm stuck in office and, you know, I don't want to use a Swachh bag because once I come out, the next person who goes in, they know I've been using a sanitary napkin. You know, how do I address that? So we engage, you know, we have a very personal connect with a lot of people. And that's how, you know, we've been able to, you know, get the conversation going.
Okay, that's amazing. So what has the impact of Swachh been so far?
Okay. Swachh, the impact has been phenomenal, if I may say so. When I started, you know, I really didn't think that we would reach to, you know, a team of, you know, 40, 42 plus women. We started out with two of us, and then I engaged seven women. You know, but the impact it has created, obviously, I know it in numbers because, you know, I see the sales. But more than that, it has impacted so many more lives. You know, at least the sanitation workers, they don't lose their appetite anymore. A lot of times, you know, they would tell us that we don't feel like eating a meal because, you know, we've just touched an old sanitary napkin. We've lost our appetite. We don't want to eat. you know, the kind of relief that has come to them, that is the impact that we were trying to, you know, to have, and we have done that. And also, you know, a lot of our ladies have been able to support their families. You know, first they were not allowed to work. Then, you know, slowly, slowly, when they started seeing that, you know, the money is actually going to help them, then, you know, the attitude of their home, you know, the people in their houses changed. So, you know, changing any mindset has an impact, you know, of its own. And that's what we've been able to address.
That is extremely inspiring. Thank you so much. So, what is the next step, you know, on your to-do list for Swachh? What is the next big thing or small thing for that matter?
Sure. So, I actually have been thinking about a couple of more products that I want to add to Swachh. But I don't know, for some reason, I just haven't, because in the case of Swachh bags for sanitary napkins, I think Satyamev Jayate did all the research for me. So I didn't have, you know, to actually do anything. I saw everything in front of me, and, you know, I just dove in. But with other products, I think I still have to do that. So I haven't done it already. But it is going to be, you know, things that are made out of recycled newspaper. And, you know, with Swachh also and any other product that I create, my aim is to, you know, add value to every link in the supply chain. You know, whether it's the manufacturer or, you know, the vendors from who we buy. For example, the printer who prints our labels, he is actually visually impaired. You know, so that's why I go and, you know, I choose to work with him, you know, to support these kind of people. You know, that's the aim. And I have two other products in mind. Hopefully, maybe before the lockdown, even if I can launch one, it would be great.
Okay. Okay. Beautiful. There's so much to learn from you, you know, actually. From the time you started till now, I already feel so inspired, you know, from every little thing that you have done, right from supporting people to coming up with a concept that's actually helping sanitation worker.
Thank so, you. I told you I talk too much.
No, that's lovely. Love it.
Thank you.
So, what are your favorite moments from the journey? Anything that made you really happy or proud? Something that's been very touching, favorite moments from the journey?
Yeah, in fact, you know, every moment with Swachh is, you know, like you said, you have so much to learn from me, but I have so much to learn from the ladies that I work with. One of my most, you know, memorable things was when one of our ladies, she actually saved up all her money, because we actually created bank accounts for everybody. So, you know, so she saved up all that money and then she bought a laptop for her daughter. You know, and she said that, you know, I don't want my daughter to do what I'm doing. I want to educate her. And, you know, I wanted to do something, you know, similar to what you're doing. And the next day I went there to visit all of them to take count of the bags. And she actually brought her daughter along with the laptop. And, you know, her daughter tells me that, you know, okay, madam, now you see, now even I will learn how to use Excel like you. You know, so you know these kids, they actually take note of, you know, what you're doing, you know, the numbers I'm working
with,
how you do. You know, yeah, so that was very nice. And I had actually been to another lady's house, because, you know, she would keep telling me come home. So one day I just decided to drop in to her house, and when I went, I saw a mini factory kind of a setup there. All the members of her house were working on Swachh, and, you know, in the limited space that she had, she had actually set up her entire hall with a TV. And, you know, so one would be cutting. So first comes the cutting, then comes the folding, and everybody had their own jobs to do. You know, I don't think I was that organized even when I allotted work to them. But, you know, I learned from them that in your limited space, you know, how you best utilize your time, your space, who is good at what. And, you know, so these things, you know, actually make me really happy. And the other one was one of the most recent ones was during the lockdown, when a customer from Bombay had texted us and asked us if we were available to deliver. But at that time, the transporters were not working and we were out of stock on almost all the sites that were listed on. And even though I had the stock, we didn't have a way to, you know, get them across to her. And she said that, you know, from the last 1 year, I have been using only Swachh bags. Now I'm stocked out. And, you know, your product is an essential. It's an essential commodity. So how can it not be available? You know, so that was a very touching moment for me, you know, when, you know, along with sanitizers and masks, when a customer tells you that, you know, they feel your product is an essential commodity, you know, that is one of the biggest compliments ever.
Hello.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, probably there was a connection error in the end. So what is your message for all the budding entrepreneurs, especially female entrepreneurs who want to, you know, start from somewhere, start something of their own?
Sure. So, you know, I don't know, just go for it and, you know, just take the risks. When I started Swatch, you know, I had a very limited budget to start with because I didn't have a job at that time. So I didn't want to spend too much money. But, you know, the idea is that, you know, if you put in the right resources and, you know, think of something novel, then you don't really need, you know, too much to start off with. But, you know, take the risks because, you know, you would rather, you know, try and fail, you know, than to never try. But, you know, the money is something that you can put. But, you know, the hustle is all that matters. You know, like they say, one of my favorite quotes is, you know, the dream is always free, but the hustle is what costs. You know, the hustle is sold separately. You know, you have to be out there, have to do it. And if you're not willing to go 100% into it, then just don't start at all.
Okay. So that conviction is needed. Like, you have to be extremely sure. And you have to have that kind of conviction and courage to just get into it. You know, I mean, do you think that is like the most important?
Sure. But I feel even if you're not sure, just go for it, because, you know, it may work, it may not work. I have tried so many things that haven't worked. You know, pre-Swatch, I had even started a mystery shopping, a small setup. I had a project. So, you know, where we would engage a lot of mystery shoppers because that was the rage at the time. But that didn't work. But it's okay. You know, I tried. That was something I wanted to do. And I failed at that, but it's okay because, you know, it gave me so many contacts. I'm still in touch with those people today. And, you know, so even if you're not sure about something, just go for it, take the risk. If it works, it works. If it doesn't work, it's okay. You know, try something else.
Okay, so where can we find Swatch on Instagram, Facebook, your handles?
Yes. We have, we're pretty active on Instagram and Facebook. On Instagram, I will just message the handles of Insta and Facebook. And to buy, we are available on most online marketplaces, where they're on Flipkart, we're on Nykaa, we're on 1MG, we're on netmeds.com, and we're in a couple, you know, in pharmacies and brick and mortar stores in Chennai.
And in the pink box as well.
And on the pink box, in every... Absolutely, Sanjana. And in every pink box. Like it or not, we're there in every pink box.
Okay, yeah. Thank you so much, Anisha. It was wonderful hosting you. I am very happy that I got to do this. And
so does that mean I have one more customer?
Oh, yeah. I have one of your bags, by the way.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah. So, Sanjana had told me about you, and I have one of your bags because she had... she gave me a pad when I needed it. That's exactly how I have one of your bags, and, you know, I love it so much actually that I've kept it. Like, okay, yeah, this is something that I can use to at least carry my pads everywhere.
Right. The idea is, you know, just to be travel friendly, and, you know, be handy at any given time.
Absolutely. Yeah. We even have a little message from Kritika, who conducted the previous session. She says that it's so inspiring to hear your story and so happy to see that someone in India has thought about sanitary disposal bags. She remembers seeing the concept when she lived in Melbourne when she was studying there, but she didn't really see any when she went back to India. So thank you, Anisha.
Thank you, and thank you, Kritika.
Thank you, Jyoti. Thank you, Anisha. This was such an amazing session.
Thank you, Jyoti. Thank you for being so patient.
Welcome. Oh, come on. It was wonderful. Trust me.
So thank you so much, Anisha, for being here. We are so happy to have hosted you. And thank you, Jyoti, for agreeing to be a host for Crimson Corn. I will
always
see you again for the 7 o'clock session.
Yes, I will see you.
Yeah. Awesome.
Thank you, Sanjana.
Thank you, Anisha. So we will be starting the next session at 7:30, and this session is about switching to menstrual cups. The facilitator is somebody who I absolutely adore and love so much, Angelique. She will be here at 5:30. So let's all take 10 and just kind of refresh ourselves a little bit. I have just finished my cup of chai. I recommend everybody has one cuppa as well. And yes, I will see you guys again at 5:30. Thanks, Jyoti. Thanks, Anisha.
Thank you. Bye, guys.
See you. Bye-bye. Bye.